Thank you, Dolly Parton Imagination Library.
Wanted to thank you so much for your Imagination Library, and we look forward to the books every month. Thank you again.
Say thank you, Dolly Parton Imagination Library. Say thank you.
Well, thank you.
Hi, Dolly. Your Imagination Library program is changing lives for children and families, not only here in the state of Delaware, but all over the world. You are truly a visionary. I can't express how honored and grateful I am to be able to help carry out this program here in Delaware. Thank you so much again, Dolly.
We love them.
Dolly, thank you so much for inspiring children and their families to connect through books. That's going to make a huge impact for generations to come. And I am just so grateful and honored to be able to contribute to your mission. Thank you so much.
Our children are so excited when they check their mailboxes and find new books waiting for them each month. Books selected for them based on their age and development. Dolly Parton's Imagination Library exposes our children to new authors and stories, as well as provides them with their own copies of favorite classics to read again and again with their families. This program helps our youngest learners enter kindergarten with a love of books and an excitement to learn.
That's a tough act to follow. How about everybody?
Thank you for the books.
Thank you for the books.
Excellent. Before I start, just one additional piece of housekeeping. As you would expect at an event like this, please no recording of the event and no flash photography. I mean, we don't care if you record us, but you don't want to do that anyway. So please no recording and no flash photography. Thank you very much. Good afternoon, friends, and thank you for being here. As most of you know, my name is Tracey Quillen Carney, and for the 99% of you who are from Delaware, I'm your First Lady. please join me in just a few of the many thank yous that are due today. First, thank you to our wonderful opening act, an organization that serves our youth in so many ways, the Choir School of Delaware. As you may have noticed, we will also hear from the Wilmington Children's Chorus a little later, another organization that advances equity in its empowerment of young people. Thank you for being here. Thanks to Jamar Rahming there in the back. And to all of our friends here at the beautiful landmark Wilmington Public Library. The library's history dates back to 1754. And this year it is celebrating its 100th anniversary in this location. Thank you to our state librarian, Annie Norman. And to all of our Delaware libraries and staff. And he doesn't have to stand up, but thank you, Secretary Jeff Bullock, who's hiding. And his team at the Department of State. Thanks to our birth hospitals, who are registering newborn Delawareans for Dolly Parton's Imagination Library before they go home from the hospital. Woo. And thank you to all of our early education centers, pediatric offices, and the many community organizations that help families to learn about the program and get signed up. There are many more thanks due, but I'll name just one more group saved until the end. Thanks to the governor. And to the legislators and all the other elected officials and their staffs. Thank you for supporting the Imagination Library in its pilot and then statewide launch, and for recognizing how essential it is to support healthy brain development towards school readiness. Thank you very much. So with gratitude to all of you who do the real work, it is my privilege to serve as the honorary chair, or as Secretary Bullock likes to say, the godmother of Dolly Parton's Imagination Library in Delaware. And it is now my added privilege to introduce the governor, someone for whom I have a certain fondness, John Carney.
I think you heard the little ones in the back, which are participants in the Imagination Library. I'm tempted to yield my time to them, and they can tell the real story. I do want to welcome the mayor, Mayor Przycki, and members of City Council are here with us as well. Thanks for joining us and for your great work. Is this cool or what? Yes. Totally cool. In my top three, I think, in my years as public service. I do want to echo Tracy's thanks, recognizing the incredible team effort of the Delaware Libraries and Partners, led by our state librarian, who's already been recognized, but we can recognize her again. And all those who made this Imagination Library possible, including Earl Jakes, who brought it to us from Nashville, Tennessee. So I think we have a few visitors from out of state, but for those of you who are special guests today, this is how we like to do things in Delaware. We're a state of neighbors, as I like to say. Our former governor did as well, and we work together in and beyond government for the common good and to secure the promise of our future for our children and generations to come, and what a tremendous program in doing that. That said, it's not really very hard work to unite people behind an effort and an idea as simple and as essential as this one, and the cheerleader that we're going to hear from in a minute. Children from birth to age 5, as Tracy said, receive a high-quality book in the mail every month, free of charge, including those little ones in the back. And every child in our state is eligible to enroll. So, the mission is pretty easy to sell, all the more because, as far as I can tell, there is nobody in the state of Delaware who doesn't love Dolly Parton. We have some cabinet secretaries up here in the front row who might need smelling salts in a minute. That love is beyond the measure of her awards and her accomplishments in music, film, TV, as an author, a business leader, philanthropist, and more. Too many honors and hits to name. It's not just being inducted into the multiple halls and walks of fame, being named a living legend, receiving a Kennedy Center honor and a National Medal of Arts, being chosen as one of Time's 100 most influential people, and recognized in the Guinness Book of World Records, or even having a species named for her. The love for Dolly Parton is beyond anything that can be measured by even the most prestigious prize, and we're seeing that born today. It is love for a true American original who speaks to us and for us, and who makes us believe in our ideals and our dreams. The Imagination Library has deepened Dolly Parton's legacy in the most meaningful possible way through service to all of our children. Please join me in a Delaware welcome for Dolly Parton.
Looking for a mic. How are you in Delaware? Thank you so much. Thank you, Governor and First Lady John Tracy. Appreciate you very much, and I'm sure you do too. Anyway, it's a great honor to be here with you today, and we're so excited that we've gone statewide with our Imagination Library. And I guess we're going to be sitting down answering a few questions, but I just wanted to say a special hello to all of you, and thanks for the wonderful welcome. Okay. Okay.
We are excited to have you here, as you can tell. Now, before we go into our conversation specifically about the Imagination Library, tell us a little bit about what you're up to now. You've got the new book and the album that goes with it, maybe a movie. What you're excited about doing and what you're looking forward to.
Well, I've got new dreams every day, as I always say, and I never know exactly what I'm going to do next, but I do know that right now I'm in the process of doing a Christmas musical. This Christmas on NBC, sometime in December, we're actually going to film that from Dollywood, our theme park up in East Tennessee, and I'm looking forward to that. I've written a lot of the songs. We're going to have a lot of wonderful guests on there, and so we're excited about all of that, and I'm just every day trying to just continue with what I've got going. I always say I dreamed myself into a corner. My dreams came true, so I have to be responsible for all the things going on, like the book that you mentioned. We've been out promoting that. James Patterson, by the way, is a wonderful guy, and we've just become good friends, and I know a lot of you have read his book, so I was honored to be part of that whole Run, Rose, Run. So I've just got something going on all the time, and I just got inducted, or going to get inducted into the Rock and Roll. I said, oh my Lord, I never thought of myself as a rock star. When people used to say to me, oh, you're a rock star, you rock, I just thought they were just bragging on me like I was cool or something. But dang if they didn't actually put me in there or going to. That's a great honor. I didn't expect that. But I'm just always proud of all the wonderful things going on. And I am never prouder of anything that I've ever accomplished than I am with the Imagination Library.
So our audience here is pretty familiar with the Imagination Library, but tell us a little bit about how you came up with the idea and who inspired it.
Well, actually, my own father inspired it. My dad, Lee Parton, was one of the greatest people, just a hard-working farmer, raising 12 kids, and just to the sweat of his brow and the bend of his back, so to speak. But my dad didn't get a chance to go to school. He couldn't read or write, as so many people in the mountains didn't get to, because the schoolhouses were usually a long ways off, and they had a whole bunch of kids. So all the kids used to have to go to work in the fields and doing whatever they could to try to help support the rest of the family. And my dad was always bothered by that, and I loved my daddy, and I was bothered by the fact that he was bothered with it. So I came up with the idea to do something great where children could learn to read at a very early age in their most impressionable years. So I came up with the idea to start this little program, the Imagination Library. And by the way, that was so cute, the kids, all so sweet. I love that. But anyhow, I thought maybe it would maybe go to a county or two over. Never imagined that it could be all that it has become. But my dad got to live long enough to see it doing good, and he got such a kick out of hearing the kids call me the book lady. So my dad passed away a few years back, but I'm so happy that he got to live long enough to see it doing good, and I always know he's with me everywhere I go talking about this. So that's how it all came to be, just putting hands, you know, books in the hands of children where they can learn to love to read, and they get their little book every month from the time they're born. Once a month, they get their little book with their own name on it. They run to the mailbox when they're old enough to walk or get out there, and they make someone in the family read with them. So I think it's really a bonding thing as well for the kids with the families and all that. So it's just something that's very precious to me.
So obviously, we're very proud of our program, our statewide program here in Delaware. So we touch a lot of children, some of whom are in the back. They came all the way up here.
Hi there.
See all those
good to see
ones?
All of you.
We also have some
Look at them.
Anticipating. We got one on the way here.
Oh, great. Oh, I already saw that. That was Jack, you said? Yeah, I remembered. She took a picture with me early on. I said, who is this? She said, that's going to be.
Got to increase the number by ones.
I know. Jack will be on that list.
And we have others who've participated as well. Our state engineer, who's children, and we've got Evangeline there, who works for my.
I met Angeline too.
I know you did.
I did.
She did. And we have people who've been to Dollywood. Did you
Great.
Ever think
Keep
that?
Coming. I always say I need the money. It costs a lot to look this cheap.
Did you ever think that it would touch this many people?
Well, I never thought that it. At that time, I wasn't thinking in those terms at the time. I just wanted to do something great for the kids, the little kids, because I love kids. I grew up in a family of 12 of them. My dad was responsible, you know, for all of us, of course, and my mother was a precious mother as well. But I had no idea that we would be all over the world now. You know, we're all over the United States, and thanks so much to Delaware for taking it statewide. We're really doing well. Getting it done in different states. So it's just a great honor for you to take this on with us and all the wonderful people locally that kind of get out there and help with it. And you know, it's all always kind of sponsored by and continued by the people locally in your hometown. So I love that. And so I just think it's a great thing that we're involved in, and so excited about the growth of it, no matter where we are.
It's a little easier in our state to take it statewide than maybe in some place.
Well, it is, but it's important. Every little thing is important. It doesn't matter one or two people or whether it's 100 or 1,000, but we're just doing really good. We send out like 2 million books a month, and so far we've given 185 million books away to children since we started, and we're hoping by early this coming year that we'll reach that 200 million mark. And that's a lot of books
that's
in the hands
of
a lot of children, and I take a lot of pride in that.
The Imagination Library, I guess, is sort of the crown jewel of your philanthropy, but you've done so much more. From medicine to education to helping people recover from natural disasters, you and your foundations have made some really critical investments. And I wonder if you could speak a little about how the philanthropy relates to your own experience. And it's way too early, as you said, with new dreams every day, it's way too early to think about legacy. But if you could choose what you would want to most be known for, most remembered for.
Well, I want to be remembered for all the things that I've done. Of course, my music was always so important to me. And I left the Smoky Mountains with a sack of songs and my little guitar and hoping to become famous with that. But I also hope to be famous, rich and famous, so I could be able to help. And I do believe that when you are in a position to help, you should help. And I think a lot of the artists do that. And I know that it means a lot to me. And even though, to answer your question, I'm proud of everything that I've done, I have to honestly say the Imagination Library is right up there in the top three of everything that I've done. So I really, I want to be remembered by the children and to know that I've tried to help with that.
Along with many people in this room, the librarians especially, I've been lucky to have a chance to read Dolly Parton Imagination Library books with a lot of the kids around our state, virtually and in person. And it's a wonderful collection, and it includes a couple of books you wrote yourself.
Yeah.
Including The Coat of Many Colors, your famous song. What made you decide to turn that particular song into a book, and what does it mean to you?
Well, that little song has just had so many lives. It's like a cat, you know. It's had at least 9 lives. But it's a true story based on a little coat that my mama made for me, trying to make me proud of the fact that she had to make it out of rags. But she read this story from Joseph in the Bible and the little coat of many colors. But the song itself really talks about compassion, the family. It addresses bullying. People that are different, you're not, you know, making fun ain't funny, so to speak. And so it means that, but the fact that they actually teach, in a lot of schools, they teach the philosophy from the Little Coat of Many Colors and read that, teaching those very things that I was talking about, but it just means so much to me that that we have it in the Imagination Library. My first book, one of the things that I remember most was a little book called The Little Engine That Could, and that's the first song, I mean the first book that we put into the Imagination Library, because it teaches children, you know, to have confidence and that you can do it. And I just always thought, you know, I think I can. And so I just up and done it. But I always think of myself as the little engine that did. So I think that's a good little book. And the other little book that I have is called I Am a Rainbow, and it's about all the moods of children, like jealousy being green and yellow being a coward, pink being happy, blue meaning being moody, and it teaches like how to deal with all those moods. But the Code of Many Colors actually today brought something for you to add into the Imagination Library here. Is it time for me to do that? Y'all done asking me questions? Are you done quizzing me?
Are there any questions we wished we had asked you?
No, I just want to again thank all of you. I guess everybody pretty much knows who I am. I'm all over the place. I get sick of me myself. I'm pretty sure some of you are, but as long as I'm around, I'm going to be doing everything I can to try to make life better for anybody and everybody, especially the little kids. So speaking of that, I wanted to kind of I brought something for you to put in the Delaware Imagination Library. So let me get over here and, let me make sure I don't get a heel hung in one of these cracks up here. Well, my shoes were handmade. I can't find them high enough in the store for me. But anyhow, let me, I'm going to hide some of you, but we'll move around. So this is a big, over-exaggerated copy of the Code of Many Colors book that we want to put in your Imagination Library and to keep here. And so thank you so much.
I think we have folks that have that book that brought, can you, those of you who brought the Code of Many Colors, I know we, there we go.
Oh,
we got them all
well, look at
place.
That. Oh, you do. Did you bring your own or did they give you that? They pass it them out over
know.
There. I'd like one and make all of you sign it. Yeah. Okay. Are you?
All right, so we have some gifts for you.
Okay.
Right? You know, our mascot is the Delaware Blue Hen. Right?
Okay.
It's a
Blue Hen.
Blue Hen. We have one of our university mascots is named after it, and we just had a nuclear submarine with that as the mascot. We're very proud of it. And we have a little baby blue hen that is the mascot for our early reading program.
Oh, okay.
Your first library card program. And so we have a couple of those little birds.
Okay.
Right here.
Well, a little bird told me. read with me, it says, Delaware Library. Okay, libraries.
One of the things we're known for in Delaware is our Atlantic Ocean beaches.
Okay.
We have some people here from Sussex County.
Hey.
This is the lower part of our state. And one of the things that you have to get when you come to Delaware is saltwater taffy that we call Dollies.
Oh, you do?
It's Dollies with an E, but today it's going to be Dollies with a Y.
Okay, well, thank you. This is Delaware stuff, kind of like our goo-goo clusters are out of Nashville, right? So this
That's
is
right.
good. Well, it is Dollies. That's nice.
Pretty
I was
nice.
Meant to have this.
It was meant to
yeah.
have that.
Yeah, I'm going to probably wreck all my crayons eating that taffy.
So your gift is just wonderful, but I'm sure what these folks would really see as an extraordinary gift was if you could sing us a song.
You think oh, you, you know that? I will.
Come on.
Okay. Well, thank you so much. Okay. All right. Okay, they got to get me kind of set up here. Going to get me a mic and get me, I guess they're going to need this microphone, but I talk loud enough for you to hear me anyhow, right? Okay, is that the one I'm using? Okay. This one works too? Oh, I want to sign that. Okay. Oh, by the way, my handsome guy that brought me up here, this is Jeff Conyers. He is the president of the Imagination Library. So, and he has done such a wonderful job. So we flew in here together. I was going to drag you up one way or the other, so I'm glad you just walked up on me. Okay, you want to take that? Okay, somebody. Yeah, I'm going to sign this. Yeah, I needed to do that. So this book belongs to you, Delaware. That says this book belongs to you, Delaware. Look, Dolly Parton. Okay. How about a nice hand for Jeff? Thank you. Without him, we wouldn't even be here today. He's done such a great job. And this fellow right here, Steve Summers, he's our creative director, and he's going to put this on without breaking my hair. I hope. Okay, you got it? All right. Well, anyhow, I'm making a lot of noise. Anyway, I was talking about my daddy. I mentioned my mom casually, but I had the best mom and dad that you could have. And if you're blessed to have a good mom and dad, I think that's one of the greatest gifts that God can ever bestow on you. And I really, this little song, as we mentioned, means a lot to me because that's how my mom was. She knew we didn't have nothing, but she was just the kind of person that could tell you anything, make you sound good. She could cook anything, make it taste good. When you thought there wasn't a thing in the world to eat in the house, Mama would just cook up a bunch of stuff, and you think, how did she do that? Anyway, she also was pretty handy with a needle and thread, and she made all of our clothes, remade them, made all the quilts for our beds and all that. She was just special, and when she did make a little coat for me, actually, because it was getting cold, and people used to bring Mama big boxes of scraps for her because they knew she had a bunch of kids and she needed them for patching and all that. So anyway, this particular time she made this little coat for me, and the song pretty much tells the story. So why don't I just hush and sing you the song? What do you think? Okay, here I go. Back through the years I go wandering once again, back to the seasons of my youth. And I recall a box of rags someone gave us, and how my mama put the rags to use. There were rags of many colors, but every piece was small. I didn't have a coat, and it was way down in the fall. Mama sewed the rags together, so in every piece with love she made my coat of many colors that I was so proud of. While Mama sewed, she told a story from the Bible she had read about a coat of many colors Joseph wore. And then she said, I hope this coat will bring you good luck and happiness, and I just couldn't wait to wear it, and Mama blessed it with a kiss. My coat of many colors that my Mama made for me, made only from rags, but I wore it so proudly. And although we had no money, I was rich as I could be in my coat of many colors Mama made for me. So with patches on my breeches, holes in both my shoes, in my coat of many colors, I hurried off to school just to find the others laughing and making fun of me in my coat of many colors Mama made for me. And oh, I couldn't understand that, 'cause I felt I was rich, and I told them of the love Mama sewed in every stitch. Even told them all the story Mama told me while she sewed, and why my coat of many colors was worth more than all their clothes. They didn't understand it, and I tried to make them see. One is only poor, only if they choose to be. It's true we had no money, but I was rich as I could be. In my coat of many colors, Mama made for me, 'cause she made it just for me.
Thank you! Thank you! Oh, thank you, that's very sweet. Well, if I'm getting a standing ovation, I guess I better sing another one. Oh, thank you so much. Well, you can go ahead and sit down. I will sing another one. I had to get rid of that bracelet. It was driving me crazy, banging on my guitar here. But anyway, of course, when I started the Imagination Library 26 years ago, I thought, well, I'm going to need a theme song for it. And I thought, well, what does it need to be? It needs to have the same kind of message that the little engine that could. Only I thought, well, maybe I'll record it. So it needed to be a little more, of an adult song. But the message is the same. Whether you're big or whether you're little, you have to try. Whether it's trying to make your dreams come true as an adult or as a little child, you have to have faith in your dreams and in yourself. So I thought, well, I'll just write a song called Try. And here it is. Okay. I have chased after rainbows. I've captured one or two. I've reached for the stars, and I have even held a few. I've walked that lonesome valley, topped the mountains, soared the sky. I've laughed and I have cried, but I have always tried, 'cause I've always been a dreamer. And dreams are special things, but dreams are of no value if they're not equipped with wings. So secure yourself for climbing. Make ready for the sky. Don't let your chance go by. You'll make it if you try. So try to be the first one up the mountain, the highest flying dreamer in the sky. And try your best to be an inspiration for others that are still afraid and shy. And try to make the most of every moment, 'cause if you never try, you never win. So try each day to try up and try again. You know, nothing is impossible if you can just believe. Don't live your life in shackles when faith can be the key. The winner's one that keeps determination in his eyes, who's not afraid to fly and not afraid to try. So try to be the first one up the mountain, and try to be the first to touch the sky. And don't let somebody tell you you can't do it. And if they say that, show them it's a lie. If you fail, you'll never really know if you don't try. And the first step is the one that's always hardest. But you'll never really know if you don't try.
God bless you, Delaware. I will see you another time.
Thank you. All
right. Thank you so much.
Up, Yela Yela, a Xhosa song of welcome from South Africa. Please welcome the Wilmington Children's Choir.
Tiwi, 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 ti
What do you think? Woo! Awesome. Thank you. Thank you to the choir school who got us kicked off today. Thank you to State Librarian Annie. Hands again together for Annie. Jeff Bullock, Secretary Bullock, Department of State. Everybody who made today's program possible. Was that cool or what? Mr. Mayor, what do you think? Awesome. Really cool. Really cool. And the program's so incredibly important. The Imagination Library, a book a month. Earl, thanks for bringing it to Delaware. Thanks for our support in the legislature. I can't think of anything more important than making sure that all our children can read and read at grade level by grade three. So thank you all for coming. And how about another round of applause for Dolly Parton? Was that great? Have a great day.